Good afternoon. My name is Don Colbert from the Ashland Police Department. I'd like to bring you the latest news update for the past week. On Thursday, November 23, 1995, Officer Murray of the Ashland Police Department located a missing juvenile. And in a subsequent investigation, she was charged with possession of a handgun and ammunition. On Friday, November 24th, Officer Peterson arrested a Peter Cobb of Framingham for violation of a restraining order. On Saturday, November 25th, Officer Bowden responded to a two-car accident in front of Sunnyside Liquors on Route 126 that tied up traffic for 45 minutes. On Monday, November 27th, the fire department reported vandalism to the Christmas trees and lights downtown. It was over $200 of vandalism done to the lights out there. On Wednesday, November 29th, Sergeant Whitney arrested a Juan Vegas of Ashland on outstanding warrants. The gun buyback program that started last week, over the past week, we've received 17 handguns and rifles, shotguns, to the police station. This is a great program, and for every gun turned in, a $50 gift certificate to Toys R Us is given to the person. The Ashland Police over the past month have had three cases involving juveniles and handguns. Please take the time to remove and secure all weapons in your household. This is very important. This is a great time of the year. The holidays are here, and it's a great tragedy to have a young child or a youth hurt by a firearm. And now I would like to turn you over to the Christmas tree lighting across the center of town here. Thank you.
News. My name is Stephanie Mathias. This is Rebecca Henry and Laura LaDuke. We're here at the 1995 Christmas tree lighting ceremony. I'd say we have about 300 or 400 people here tonight. We're here at Santa's house. Let's see what's going on.
JT, did you find your mother? JT, did you find your mother?
Okay. Hi, I'm Stephanie Mathias, and I'm here with Santa Claus. Santa, could we have a word with you for a moment? Hi. Nobody else asks you this. What would you like for Christmas?
Oh, I have what I want for Christmas.
And what is that?
All the little kids.
That's nice. So Santa, what are some of the most popular things that people have asked for Christmas?
Santa for the boys and Bobby for the girls.
Yeah, that's a good. Yeah. All right, that was Santa Claus.
See Santa, we'll get a good day.
Over there, but I sort of missed out on it, so I don't know, maybe a new car.
How many people have so far gone to the Santa house?
About 100, 150.
Wow.
A lot, lots of fun. How old is it?
My two front teeth. What do I want for Christmas? Probably really cool clothes. And you want for Christmas?
I want a dog that doesn't bite.
This is a young lady that wants.
Hello, I'm Pearl Oliver, and as we have just seen, Christmas has officially come to Ashland with the lighting of the Christmas tree and the expression of very special Christmas wishes. And as it has done in the past, Boston Ballet's production of The Nutcracker has once again officially ushered in the Christmas season for Boston and Metro West, and it is more exciting and more entertaining than ever, with brand new costumes by David Walker and glamorous and sumptuous scenery by Senin Pond, and choreography, brand new choreography for the snow scene and the Waltz of the Flowers by Boston Ballet's resident choreographer Daniel Pelsick, it would not be exaggerating to declare that this is the most breathtaking production of all. And the fabulous Grand Pas de Deux at the second act, well, right here, I'm going to show you some pictures, actually, of Paul Thrussell and Adriana Suarez. But as you know, the Boston Ballet rotates all these wonderful parts among its principal and soloist dancers. And the production that I was attending had Patrick Armand and Pollyanna Ribeiro as the cavalier to the Sugar Plum Fairy. Oh, I can't tell you how wonderful they were. It was like absolutely perfect synchronization. Perfect. They moved as one. And when this happens, it ignites special sparks in us, the viewing audience. Nadia Thompson danced Coffee with a great deal of vivacity and passion. Passion is sort of transmitted. It crosses over the stage, it bridges the aesthetic distance, and it touches the heart of the viewer. It was absolutely wonderful. Roger Cunningham, as the Nutcracker, was a dashing and stalwart cavalier to Adriana De Vitri's bewitching Clara. And here she is with Dr. Drosselmeyer. Definitive Dr. Drosselmeyer, Laszlo Berdo. Absolutely fantastic. Now here you can catch a glimpse of the new scenery. As you can see, Clara and the Nutcracker are in the balloon that's going to whisk them away. And for the first time, Dr. Drosselmeyer was hoisted up into the air and flew, just soared aloft. It was a very dramatic scene. And when I spoke to Laszlo later, he said it was awfully exciting to do it. And it's very special. Now, all these brand new touches have been added so that if you haven't really made it a tradition, a Christmas tradition, to view the Nutcracker, it's never too late to start. And you've got to make sure that every single child that you know gets a chance to see the Nutcracker. There's a total of 51 performances from the beginning, and of course it's already begun, until December 31st. That's New Year's Eve, when they have the final performance of the Nutcracker. Christmas simply would not be Christmas without a production of Boston Ballet's Nutcracker. And of course, you know, it's at Boston's Wang Center for the Performing Arts. Ballet, more than anything, is an artistic experience of unsurpassable cultural and aesthetic value for any age. And it opens up a world of sheer beauty and magic and incomparable entertainment. It's absolutely fabulous. Don't miss this new production of Boston Ballet's The Nutcracker. For WACA, Ashland News, I'm Pearl Oliver.
T'was the night before Christmas, and here at my house, I was alone with my brother, the louse. He was teasing and taunting and calling me names. He tied me up tight, his idea of a game. And he told me a story, and I started to cry. He said,
"There's no Santa.
It must be a lie.
Santa's a fake. He doesn't exist. It's our parents,"
he said,
"that buys us our gifts."
"You're lying," I yelled. He laughed with delight. "I'll prove it," I said, "and I'll do it tonight." I gathered my jacket, mittens, and boots, and went out to find that famous red suit. I started downtown, where I'd seen him before. I saw him last week at the department store. I waited in line to see old St. Nick. I needed some answers, and I needed them quick. I took a deep breath, and I pushed past his elf. "I'll prove he is real to the louse and myself." I said, "Are you real?" And he said with a grin,
"Of course, my dear child."
Then I tugged at his chin. His beard came right off, and I let out a scream. I couldn't believe it. It must be a dream. To the house I did dash and straight to my bed. No Santa Claus. I'd rather be dead. I started to cry and continued to weep until at last I drifted to sleep. I woke to a sound, a faint little jingle, like that from the bells of good old Kris Kringle. There he stood, and I stared with delight at this mysterious man. What a curious sight. He knelt on one knee beside my bed, and I'll never forget the words that he said.
I am very real, and I will remain that way too, because I live in the hearts of children like you.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!